Yeah.
Okay, no. Okay. This is for, okay. Thank you for the introduction. So, in our paper, we revisit continuously malleable secret sharing for achieving a new flavor of security. In particular, let's start with a brief introduction to secret sharing. In secret sharing, there is one party called the dealer that has a secret message and wants to share it among other N parties, S1, SN, and in such a way that only certain subsets of the set of the parties can reconstruct the message. In particular, we have the notion of access structure, that is a monotone class of subsets of the set of the parties. And here we have the authorized subsets that are all the subset of parties belonging to the access structure. And there are the unauthorized subsets that are all the other subsets of parties. In secret sharing, we have two properties. The correctness property that states that every authorized subset of parties can fully reconstruct the message. And the privacy property that states that no unauthorized subset of parties can obtain any information about the underlying secret. Now, suppose that you are an evil attacker that wants to learn at all costs some information about the message, and suppose you cannot fully corrupt an entire authorized subset of parties. Then you could try to slightly modify all the shares, for example, installing a malware or via electrical signals or something. And and you could try to see the result of this modification to the message. This kind of attack is called tampering attack and works as follows. The attacker chooses a tampering function F among a restricted family of functions, capital F, and then uses it to modify shares S1, Sn into shares S1 prime, Sn prime. And then the attacker also specifies the authorized reconstruction subset T that is used in order to reconstruct the message M prime. Now, in classical secret sharing, we have no guarantees on M prime. So if the secret sharing scheme is involved in some other scheme for which the secret message is also the private key, we have the attacker could fully could success in performing a related key attack. So in particular, it may be also reconstruct entirely the message, and this is a very big problem. To overcome this problem, Goyal and Kumar in 2018 came up with the notion of non-malleable secret sharing that informally states that the scheme remains secure even if the attacker is allowed to tamper once. In particular, they achieve information theoretic security, and they give this definition in which the resulting message M prime is either the original message or it is completely unrelated. And they also state that this is impossible to achieve for arbitrary function families. And so they find a scheme initially for independent tampering. Suppose now that the attacker can perform this kind of attack continuously. In particular, he specifies the first tampering function, the first reconstruction set, and obtains the first message, then the second function and reconstruction set, and so on. Now, a scheme that is secure against this kind of attack is called continuous non-malleable. And at the moment, there is only one construction achieving continuous non-malleability, that is by Faoni and Venturi. And they achieve computational security with a self-destruct feature that informally states that whenever the first invalid reconstructed message happens, the entire system self-destructs and the attacker is not more allowed to perform any tampering attempt. So they also prove that it is impossible to achieve continuous non-malleability in the information theoretic setting or without this self-destruct feature. And they achieve security against independent tampering and for a particular class of access structures that are threshold access structure, in which the authorized subset of parties is authorized if only if the number of parties are above a certain threshold. Actually, they achieved security for a slightly weaker version of secret sharing called RAM secret sharing, in which there is a little gap between the privacy threshold and the reconstruction threshold. As a bonus property, they obtain leakage resilience. That informally states that this scheme remains secure even if the attacker is allowed to leak some, to learn some information from all the shares. So, we designed two new continuous non-malleable secret sharing schemes for arbitrary access structures. In particular, our first scheme is in the common reference string model, in which there is a third algorithm called initialization algorithm that outputs a reference string that is used both for the share and for the reconstruction algorithms. And we achieve security against joint tampering and assuming doubly entered trapdoor permutations and collision resistant hash functions. As a bonus property, we achieve also bounded leakage resilience. That is, the scheme remains secure even if the attacker is allowed to learn a limited amount of information from all the shares. Our second construction is in the plain model, so without the need of a CRS and without the need of a trusted third party generating this CRS. However, in this model, we obtain independent tampering security only. Here, we assume the existence of one-to-one one-way functions, and as a bonus property, we achieve noisy leakage resilience, in which the scheme remains secure even if the attacker learns any information he wants from the shares, as long as the learned information does not reduce the mean entropy of the distribution of the shares by too much. However, in this talk, I'll speak only about the CRS model, and thus introducing also our new security notion. We adopt the game-based model to give our definitions and our proofs, and in particular, here we give the definition for continuous non-malleability. So we have the attacker to the right and the challenger to the left. Here, the challenger generates and outputs the common reference string, and the attacker chooses two messages, M0 and M1, along with a k-partitioning of disjoint and non-overlapping subsets of the parties. And then, upon receiving this, the challenger computes the secret sharing of either M0 or M1, and then the attacker can start to perform all his queries. The attacker can perform two kinds of queries. In the leakage query, he sends functions G1, G beta, and the challenger computes each function on the respective subset of parties, and then the challenger outputs the result of these leakage functions to the attacker. In the second tampering, query, the attacker specifies tampering functions F1, F beta, along with the authorized reconstruction set T. And then the challenger computes each FI with input all the shares within the partition BI and obtains so all the modified shares S1 prime, SN prime. Then the challenger reconstructs all the message using the shares defined in the tampering, in the reconstruction set T. And then here are three possibilities. In the first case, the reconstructed message is an invalid message, and in this case the challenger outputs this special symbol bot and self-destructs, so the attacker is no more allowed to perform any query. In the second case, the reconstructed message could be either M0 or M1, and thus the challenger outputs this special symbol same, stating this condition, but without saying which one the reconstructed message is, and this is needed to avoid trivial attacks, and otherwise it simply outputs M prime. Then, the attacker is allowed to do such queries for a polynomial number of times, and finally he outputs a guess bit B prime, stating that trying to guess if the secret sharing was either a secret sharing of M0 or a secret sharing of M1. So our definition is that a secret sharing scheme is a K-joint, leakage-resilient, continuous non-malleable secret sharing scheme if any polynomial time attacker cannot distinguish between a secret sharing of message M0 or a message M1 except with negligible probability. We construct our scheme by generalizing the following construction of a 2 out of 2 continuous non-malleable secret sharing scheme, known also as a continuous non-malleable code in the split state model. And in particular, upon input M, we secret share it, obtaining shares S0 and S1, and then we compute the hash of each share, and we compute the zero knowledge proof of each share being each hash being the hash of the respective share. And note that in the zero knowledge proof, we also adopt the labels. So we use a zero knowledge proof supporting labels. And the label is the other hash that we didn't use in the proof. And then we reconstruct, we pack everything in order to obtain the new shares S0 star, S1 star. Here, the common reference string is the CRS for the proof algorithm plus the public key for the hash algorithm. So our natural idea is to replace the SHAR algorithm with a secret sharing scheme for arbitrary access structure. But we encounter two problems. The first problem is that the hash HI could reveal some information about the share SI. And the second problem is that permuting the shares is allowed in joint tampering. That is, the attacker could permute or switch the shares while performing a tampering query. And this scheme does not give any guarantee about this particular tampering. So we modify the construction as follows. Upon input the message M, we secret share it, obtaining shares S1, Sn. Then for each share, we use a commitment scheme instead of the hash function in order to commit the share along with its position in the vector so that permuting now is very difficult without triggering a self-destruct. And then we compute the proof PIJ of the commitment CI being the commitment of the pair I with SI using the label CJ. So here we again use a zero knowledge proof system supporting labels. So our main theorem is the following. Assuming that SHARE is a K-joint leakage resilient secret sharing scheme, COM is a statistically hiding and computationally binding commitment scheme, and PROOF is a true simulation extractable NISC, then the above scheme is a K-joint leakage-resilient continuous non-malleable secret sharing scheme. A note about the share algorithm, a K-joint leakage-resilient secret sharing scheme is a scheme has a similar definition to the continuous non-malleable one, but in this case, the attacker is not allowed to perform any tampering query. So here is the security proof strategy. The privacy is quite straightforward because privacy comes from the privacy of the underlying secret sharing scheme plus the hiding property of the commitment scheme and the zero knowledge property of the proof algorithm. For continuous non-malleability, we adopt the hybrid argument, and in particular in the first hybrid we change this proof algorithm and use the zero knowledge simulator so that we now don't need any more the shares to compute the proof PIJ. And in our second hybrid experiment, we slightly modify how we answer to the tampering queries. In particular, instead of computing the tampering and then recombining the shares, obtaining the message M prime, checking if the commitments are good and the proofs are good. Instead of doing this, we replace all this part by extracting all the shares from the modified proofs, and then we combine each subset of shares together in order to reconstruct each message, each possible message from the subset, MI prime, And then we perform all the checks on the commitment, on the proof, and we also check that all the messages in this column are all equal. If something goes wrong, as usual, we trigger a self-destruct, and otherwise we output the only message M prime that we have. And with doing so, we don't need anymore all the shares in order to compute tampering, but we only need all the shares in one of the subsets. In particular, finally, we apply reduction to the underlying secret sharing scheme, and here we simulate the adversary in the leakage oracle. We use the leakage oracle to obtain the first self-destruct index, and finally, we check that we didn't leak too much. So here, this concludes the proof. To conclude our work, we find a concrete instantiation of our scheme for logarithmic partition size. In particular, true simulation extractable NISC can be obtained from doubling ancient trapdoor permutations, and statistically hiding and computationally binding commitments can be instantiated from collision-resistant hash functions. As for the leakage-resilient secret-sharing scheme, we adopt a recent construction that achieves information-theoretic security against adaptive partitioning, but is tailored to partition size, to logarithmic partition size. So, as a first open problem, we leave it open to find out a concrete instantiation with super logarithmic partition size. We note that this happens automatically if we found a new leakage resilient secret sharing achieving super logarithmic partition size, or if we improve the one that we use now. And as a second open problem, we wonder if it's possible to achieve continuous non-malleability against joint adaptive tampering rather than selective. And although our leakage resilient secret sharing scheme, the underlying leakage resilient secret sharing scheme, achieves security against adaptive partitioning, our proof strategy breaks down if we allow the attacker to perform tampering queries with adaptive partitioning. As a third open problem, we leave it open to find a similar security notion also if this similar security notion is also valid in the plain model. Or in other words, if we can obtain continuous non-malleability against joint tampering in the plain model. And that's it. Thank you for the attention.
Hey, any questions to Gianluca? Okay, so let's thank him again.